Hello everyone, I'm Pacific the Casual Gamer, and welcome back to another Oblivion noob build. Today in this one, we're going to be talking about the High Elf. Now these videos are going to be a little bit shorter than my normal ones, because there's not a lot to say. I want to keep it simple for those of you just trying out this game. So, the High Elf. The High Elf is a magic character, but it comes with a caveat, and that is it is very weak to magic. It is extremely weak to magic. So, that kind of sucks. For the noobs, I'm gonna kind of gear this build towards like a little bit of resisting magic, but mostly just not getting hurt. So to start off, your sign is gonna be the lady. It's gonna give you endurance and willpower. And you're gonna pick magic specialization for this. That way, because magic skills in Oblivion are the hardest ones to level up. For your two attributes, you're gonna do intelligence and willpower. That's for more magic. And for your four skills, so normally you do seven skills, but for the new builds, I give you four skills and let you pick the other three in case you want to experiment with something. But for the four kind of base skills you're gonna have for this build is restoration, destruction, blade, and heavy armor. Those are kind of the four main skills that you're gonna pick with this character. Now, almost everything about the High Elf is magic. Now, they're pretty tall, so they're easier to hit, and I believe that since they're taller, they are a little tiny bit faster. I know for speed runs, everyone picks a High Elf, so I don't know if they're actually like a little bit faster. But you got the magic. Now, the hard thing with High Elf's an advanced character, is they have high magic, but they have, like, they're weak to magic. Like, it sucks. That is one of the things. If you fight in magical people, you better have some sort of skill or spell that helps you out. So if I could suggest one more kind of spell set to get you covered, it would have to be alteration. Because alteration gives you all the resist like fire and frost and all that. So that's kind of like what the High Elf is. The actual class that we're building here is called a battlemage. It's the most overpowered class in Oblivion is the battlemage. Next to like, also another one's like a nightblade. But the battle mage, where you go in, you're casting magic and sword. Like, usually the only weakness to the battle mage is they have sometimes low stamina. And sometimes they kind of can't focus on very specific things. So they sometimes are really, really weak in the mid game. So when you're using the High Elf, you're carrying a sword for close range combat, or if an enemy has magic resistance. Now for destruction, always carry at least two types of damage. You can even use restoration for an absorb health, but I usually carry around fire and lightning, or sometimes I use frost. I don't know why. To me, it seems like frost spells are always ends up being more expensive than sparks or something like that. So I usually carry around a fire-based set and a lightning-based set of skills, both of which, so usually enemies in Oblivion don't have resist magic. They have resist fire, and they have resist. I don't know what it's called, like lightning or shock. That's what it is. Shock. God, I forgot about that. So I just carry around those to counter the resistances that enemies have. And the sword again is just close range combat. If someone comes up to you and you want to save your magic to heal or something like that, you can always just kill them with a sword. So that's really it for this new build, guys. The other three slots. Put whatever you want in them. I encourage you guys, if you're a noob in this game, to just try everything. The more experiments you do, where you're like, hey, mysticism, what are all the spells I can find in mysticism? What are all the spells I can find in illusion? You know, maybe I can experiment with sneaking and heavy armor, you know? Do it all. Do it all. That way you understand this game. So, I'm Pacific the Casual Gamer. I suck just as bad as you do at video games, and I'll see you in the next episode, stream, blog, or Steam post, of whatever I decide to make.